This is Mike Sexton. Want to win at poker, finish in the money, and consistently win at cash games? Join me and other pros at a WPT boot camp. You'll get hands-on training, sharpen all aspects of your game,
I'll let you do it the right way,
and learn to play like a pro. Our 2 and 3 day camps are held at the most famous poker venues. Many students recoup their tuition after just one camp. Our goal is to make you the best poker player you are willing to be. Start winning now. Go to WPTbootcamp.com and put the odds in your favor. WPT Boot Camp, your fast track to the final table.
This portion of the show is brought to you by Danley's Garage. They build quality garages at fantastic prices. Protect your car today with a new garage from Danley's Garage. Call them at 773-427-2437.
Let's take a moment to look at the chip leaderboard brought to you by UB.net. The 2009 Windy City Poker Championship main event champion, Leroy Carver, is above his starting stack with nearly 22,000 in chips. And our lovable WPT bootcamp instructor, Nick Brancato, is struggling along with just about 1,000 in chips after coming to this feature table from one of the outside tables. Nick will be looking for a spot to double or maybe even triple up and get some chips to fight against these tough opponents.
How long are you going to stay?
Till I play Sunday.
Oh, till Sunday. Okay.
You play till Sunday too, right?
Yeah. So you're going to play that single table?
Jerry and Nick discussing our single table tournament coming to you later in our broadcast schedule. 9 players, $1,500 buy-in, winner take all. While Nicky sits down at our table with just 11 big blinds, rumor has it that he lost a bunch of his chips at the first table when he got it all in on the flop with a monster and got 2 outed on the river. That's poker, folks. He takes the crown from Jerry Yang as he's now the shortest stack at the feature table. The pot Nicky lost was a 45,000 chip pot, eek. Blinds are 50 and 100, and our short stack will be under the gun. Well, the WPT Bootcamp Pro has 9-7 unsuited, the destroyer, and he'll fold. Dave McDermott enjoying some recent action. He just limps in, and Faraz smells some weakness, and he'll raise it to 600 to go. Leroy Carver with a suited 6-5 on the button, and he's going to make the call. David Wexler says, no thank you, sir.
Beautiful.
Jerry Yang's in the big blind, makes a bit of a loose call for a discount. And he prices in Dave McDermott, who'll make the call as well. And we'll have 4 players to the flop. It's 9-9-4. Actually gives Dave McDermott the best hand. He's got 2 pair, 9s and 4s. And Faraz is going to make a continuation bet here. He knows this flop rarely hits his opponents. And Leroy's going to call with just 6 high. He knows that Faraz knows. Looks like he's going to float to take it away on the next street. And Dave, considering this, he does have 2 pair. But with 2 players and a bunch of action in front of him, he's going to make the fold.
Check. 14.
Whoa! Look at this. Faraz insta-sprinkles 5 yellow chips, a 5,000 chip check raise. And for the first time in our entire broadcast, Leroy Carver is quiet.
Makes me sad that he raised 5x my stack.
He looks like he's going to throw up.
All right, man. Good bet.
Well, Faraz with a little grin. Looks like the cat who ate the canary, and he will take down this pot.
Watch out, kids. This big blind's a tough one.
Nicky with 11 tough big blinds.
If it falls to me, I'll raise your big blind in the dark.
Thank you, sir.
I think they did, didn't they?
Well, lucky for Nick, blind should have gone up to 75-150 this hand. He'll get a bit of a reprieve.
Haven't looked yet.
Is it now?
No, I mean,
haven't looked yet.
It's the advantage of being up here.
New life, huh?
Yeah.
350.
Well, as promised, Faraz raises Nick's big blind in the dark, makes it 350
to go.
You
get a read on if I looked or not. I guess I have to show the cameras. I'm going to show the cameras right now.
Action folds around the bend, and uh-oh, Jerry Yang, perfect timing. The short stack picks up two aces in the small blind. Let's see how he's going to play this one. And he just makes the call, setting a trap. Maybe he's trying to induce a shove from Nicky Brancato here in the big blind. But Nicky just folds.
Let Jerry take care of you.
All right, I got to look now. Flop's coming. Wow, that is amazing.
Here comes the flop, King Deuce 7.
1,000.
And Faraz makes a continuation bet. Hope you saw my air quotes there. And the short stack main event champ is all in, praying for Faraz to have at least a deuce. And Faraz folds the mumbler.
Nice answer.
Can't call there with five high.
What move?
Thank you. Not nice to pick on a blind man.
Jerry tried to trap me that hand. Thought you were going to snap off my baby stack.
If I had at least one over, I would have called for fun. Serious.
Well, the blinds are going to be at 75 and 150 this hand, finally. And Nick Brancato, the short stack, is in the small blind. Dave McDermott is first to act.
Big blind is tricky. Talk me into that.
I thought for sure you were going to call.
And he will make the call.
I thought it was two, and then I
got a lot of chips.
Three and a five. I was like, what's
going
on? Well,
Clint Wimberly finally picks up a real hand, ace queen off suit, and he's going to make a raise to 500. Action folds the WSOP champ on the button. He's got two deuces. And he wants to see a flop. He'll make a call. Uh-oh, Nicky Brancato with a big hand, ace jack off suit in the small blind. Could be trouble for him. Nice fold, sees the action before him and gets out of the way. Jeremy folds, and Dave's going to see another flop with a medium ace. Action flop, 9, jack, 10. Two players with straight draws. And Clint is going to make a continuation bet. And Jerry folds the best hand. And Dave's going to check raise to 4,500 with just the straight draw.
So the check
of course, Clint has
here.
A better straight draw. He's going to make the call. He's got two overcards to the board as well. Turn is the five of diamonds. Changes
table.
Nothing.
Slow down.
the one that took 19K of my 20K stack.
That's what the other guy said.
Yeah, there's a table here, you're going to double up, it's this table.
We want you back at the table, he said.
River's a jack of hearts, this is actually a great bluffing card. And Dave's going to do just that, he bet 6,500, almost half of Clint's chips. This is a great bet. Poor Clint can't call here, he folds. Dave takes it down with a well-timed bluff. And this has been a tough feature table for Clint. He's just not picking up any hands. And when he finally does, he can't get him to connect.